History is full of strange things falling from the sky, aside from the standard rain and snow. Storms of frogs and fish are oddly not unheard of, as violent upsweeps and storms suck up huge amounts of water. But what about bits of lungs and worms? Number 10. Spider rain. Imagine driving your car, and suddenly thousands of spiders come raining from the sky. Well, that's exactly what happened to Eric Reese, a 20-year-old web designer from Santo Antonio de Platina, a town around 250 miles west of Sao Paulo. Reese, who was the videographer for his friend's wedding, had the wherewithal to pull out his video camera and tape the spider torrential, which he then posted on YouTube, which then became quite the video sensation. And while spider rain might sound like something out of a Hitchcock movie, it's a phenomenon that's actually not out of the ordinary. According to biologist Marta Fisher of the Pontifical Catholic University of Parana, the Anolosimus eximus spider, which is about the size of a pencil eraser, usually hangs out in trees and can create webs up to 65 feet high, which are used to trap insects. If a strong wind should come along, however, the web can become detached, sending the spiders aloft, which would appear as if they're raining from the skies, which is exactly what Reese was probably witnessing that fateful day. Number 9. Frog rain. According to the Bible, frogs raining down from the skies is a sign of a horrible curse. According to scientists, however, the explanation is a tad more logical. Waterspouts, which is the type of tornado that forms over a body of water, which is where frogs typically hang out, is the culprit here. When a waterspout hits a body of water, the frogs are sucked way up into the funnel and soon become an unwilling passenger in its ride away from its original habitat. Once the wind dies down, the frogs are then released full force, which then gives the appearance of frogs raining down from the heavens. Number 8. Golf balls. On September 1st, 1969, golf enthusiasts from Punta Gorda, Florida, probably thought they died and went to heaven. It was on that day that residents woke up to find dozens and dozens of golf balls falling from the skies. Was this some gift from the golfing heavens? Not exactly. According to meteorologists, Punta Gorda, which is located on Florida's western Gulf Coast and is home to many golf courses, probably experienced a passing tornado which gulped up a golf ball-filled pond, which in turn rained down its contents on the streets of the unsuspecting town. Number 7. Blood rains. If rain fell as rain does, clear and cool, nobody took much notice. But what if it turned red? Within just a few hours, the rainwater collected in basins and fountains had gone from colorless to a murky, rusty red. This is exactly what happened in Zamora, Spain. Some residents worried that chemicals had been dumped into their water. Others suspected aerial saboteurs filling the tanks with contaminants. The religiously minded worried that the blood-like rain was a plague delivered by a wrathful god. They wouldn't be the first to come to that conclusion. Blood rains, like rains of fish, are uncommon but not unheard of. In September 2001, red rain fell from the skies in Kerala, India, staining people's clothes and prompting researchers to suspect both meteor dust and alien involvement. A government report settled on a cause much closer to home: airborne algae spores. As it turns out, the Spanish blood rain, which occurred in fall of 2014, was similar to the rains in Kerala. A curious resident sent samples of the blood puddles to scientists at the University of Salamanca. The researchers examined the water and found particles of Haematococcus pluvialis, a green freshwater algae that turns red in times of chemical stress. The red color comes from a carotene pigment called astaxanthin. The scientists weren't totally shocked to find H. pluvialis in the water. Its name literally translates to blood rain algae. Number 6. Raining bats. Australia is a country in which not only people, but also animals have quite a challenging life. In January 2018, the air temperature in some areas of the continent reached a record high. In coastal cities, many Australians flocked to pools, beaches, and other watering holes to cool off. The animals had nowhere to hide. When the bats fell from the sky like rain, it became clear that these animals could not survive the temperature that had risen to 47 degrees Celsius. According to experts, about 100,000 bats died due to abnormal heat. Number 5. Raining fish. There are flying fish, and then there are falling fish. The sight of fish falling from the sky, though certainly bizarre. Imagine how surprised you would be if you go outside to do shopping, walk down the street, holding an umbrella over your head, and see small fish lying around everywhere. We believe that's quite weird, but the local stray cats think this is the best rain ever in their lives. You will probably ask that, was it possible for fish to fall from the sky? It's actually quite simple and easy to explain. This rare weather phenomenon happens when somewhere in the ocean a waterspout occurs. Low atmospheric pressure and enormously strong winds lift fish from the surface of the water to the sky. After a while, the wind brings a whirlwind of fish to the land and causes this unusual rain. Though this natural phenomenon is considered rare, it happens almost every year. For example, another fish rain occurred in Australia in March 2016. To be more precise, it happened near Winton in outback Queensland. The locals were very surprised to find fish in places with no rivers or other bodies of water nearby. That's the kind of humor Mother Nature has. Number 4. Meat. Well, it wasn't exactly raining men, but on March 3, 1876, in the little Kentucky town of Olympia Springs, it was raining meat. To be exact, the meat, which measured between 2 and 4 inches square and appeared to be of the beef variety, rained down in the backyard of one Alan Crouch. It was verified, however, after two men bravely stepped forward to taste the meat, that rather than beef, the taste was similar to mutton or venison. After further medical examination by the Royal Microscopical Society of Great Britain, it was determined that the meat was in fact lung tissue from either a horse or a human infant. As for how this all occurred, the most probable theory given was that a large pack of buzzards had probably just eaten a pack of dead horses. And when one of them expelled the meat, all the other buzzards, which is apparently a buzzard trait, then followed suit. Number 3. Frozen iguanas. While residents of Tallahassee, Florida braced for their first measurable snowfall in 28 years this January, other Floridians braced for a hailstorm of frozen iguanas. While much of the northern part of the U.S. copes with blizzard conditions, in Florida, it's raining iguanas. Florida residents have been sharing pictures of the reptiles belly up in their backyards and on the side of roads. The effect is brought on by the abnormally cold weather hitting the east coast of the United States. And green iguanas, an invasive species accustomed to warm tropical climates, are struggling to cope. Not all of the state's iguanas seen lying on the ground are dead. Many, in fact, are frozen in limbo, and some have been snapping back to life once their bodies warm. When temperatures drop below about 50 to 40 degrees Fahrenheit, their blood starts to slow and they enter a lethargic state akin to a deep sleep. Note, this makes iguanas dangerous for people to pick up as they can become defensive once they're able to move. The reason these iguanas have such a hard time coping with cold weather is simply that their reptile bodies aren't adapted to it. Number 2. Worms. Meteorologists and biologists have been left baffled by earthworms raining from the sky over southern Norway. According to Norwegian news service The Local, the most recent phenomenon was discovered by biology teacher Karsten Ørstad while he was skiing in the mountains. "I saw thousands of earthworms on the surface of the snow," he said. "When I found them on the snow, they seemed to be dead, but when I put them in my hand, I found that they were alive." He thought they might have crawled through the snow, but rejected this idea as the snow was over half a meter thick across the mountains. Following Mr. Ørstad's discovery, there have been similar reports in southern Norway and sightings of worm rainfalls in Lindis and Suldal near Bergen, and also hundreds of miles away in Femunden. According to Ørstad, it's not a new phenomenon. In 2007 in Louisiana, thousands of worms began falling from the sky. Scientists gathered it may have been from a local bayou waterspout that then dropped the creepy crawlers on the nearby town. A similar event happened in 2011 in Scotland when a storm of earthworms plummeted onto a soccer field. The Scotland instance was not explained as easily since it was a cloud-free day and the nearest water was over 40 miles away. Number 1. Non-dairy creamer. In 1969, a white powder of non-dairy creamer rained down on the town of Chester, South Carolina. It seems that just as the Borden Company was about to make a batch of the corn syrup-based drink additive, a vent clogged, causing the entire batch to shoot out of the factory and into the air. The sticky powder coated everything in town, including cars, windows, people, homes, and grass. The next morning's dew added moisture to the problem and created a giant, gooey mess. The factory was only fined $4,000 for the damage. Thank you so much for watching, and if you enjoy the video, please let me know by clicking the like button. Do share, write a comment, and don't forget to subscribe so that you can catch up my next video.